Hi everyone, and welcome to the channel. In this video, I'll be looking to see what's the best way to take cuttings from our plants. The most popular internet opinion is to cut your stems on a 45 degree angle. I want to see if this is actually the best way to do it, or if that is another internet myth. So let's get started. I've got a big pile of fresh tomato cuttings here, ready to propagate. To prepare these cuttings, I'm removing lower level branches and leaves, as well as any flower sites that are already on the plants. Next, I'll be cutting the stems in a variety of ways so we can see what method grows the fastest. First up, we have a 45 degree angle cut. People say that this increases the surface area and helps the plant to absorb water quicker. Next up, we have a 90 degree straight angle cut. This should give us a good indication if the surface area hypothesis is true. We also have a super angle cut. This has even more surface area than the 45 degree cut and should further test that hypothesis. Next, we have the splitter. This one was cut on a 90 degree angle, and then an incision was made up along the stem, creating that split. We also have a four-split version of the splitter technique. And lastly, we have a variety of end techniques with scoring up along the bottom of the stem. The bottom inch or so has had small cuts made into it just to see what happens. I have these in a 45 degree, 90 degree, and splitter options. For my smaller plants, I've got two cuttings with 45 degree angles and two cuttings with straight 90 degree angles for a good direct comparison as to what's better. We rejoin these plants on day number 5. They've started to root and we're gonna see how they compare. First up, we'll take a look at the 45 degree angle cuttings. Our first cutting here has no roots at all. And our second cutting, you can see, does have a number of small roots beginning to grow from the bottom of the stem. In comparison to our 90 degree angled cuts, the 90 degree cuttings are clearly outperforming the 45 degree cuttings. Roots on both of these cuttings, which are more numerous and definitely longer than the 45 degree angle counterparts. Moving on to our bigger cuttings, we'll start with the 45 degree angled cuts. You can see rooting on both of these plants beginning to work its way up the stem. Not too long yet, but clear signs of rooting, and this definitely works as a propagation method. Our first competitor is again the 90 degree angle cut. You can see that this 90 degree cutting has just as many roots as the other plants, and they're maybe longer. It's a very close comparison. Definitely no edge to the 45 degree angle cut in this case. Next, we'll look at our super angle cuts. If what we thought about the 45 degree angle cuttings was true, that surface area helped the plant to grow roots, these should have developed roots even faster than the 45 degree angle plant. You can see that they have barely rooted at all. There's some very small hairs at the base of the stems, but these are definitely falling behind in this race. Next up, we have our split technique. These plants are looking really well. Definitely the longest roots we've seen so far, and they're beginning to work their way up the stem of the plant. You can see they've extended about an inch or so possibly. Definitely further than the 45 degree angle cuts. I think these are a pretty clear favorite so far. Our four split technique hasn't done quite as well as the two split. You can see a number of roots developing, but those splits have really curled back on the stem, and those roots are really gonna be in a mess of a situation as they continue to develop. Our next cutting is one that we scored. It had a 45 degree angle cut and then a number of small cuts up along the stem. You can see that those small cuts have opened themselves up considerably and a lot of the inner plant is exposed here. There's some very small rooting taking place up above all of the scores, but this doesn't look to be the best idea. Our 90 degree scored plant is in a similar situation with a bit better rooting. You can see those roots only developing up above the scores. Lastly, we have a stem that was split and scored along the bottom. This one looks really good. The split technique seems to really be doing something good for these plants. You can see not a lot of rooting down along the bottom where the stem was scored. I don't think the scoring is having much benefit. It's time to pick a winner, and I think it is clearly the split technique. These plants have our longest roots and the most roots, working their way up the stem with rooting action, clearly outperforming the 45 degree angle cuts. Seeing the comparisons between our 90 degree, 45 degree, and super angled cuts, I don't think there's any clear correlation here to the surface area helping the plant to grow roots. I think we have once again been lied to by the internet.